Alright everyone, in this example we are going to duplicate a shape, and not just the shape itself because that would be copying it similarly. However, in this case we're going to make a change to it, and then when we duplicate it, it will repeat that change over and over again. So you can see here that our command is very similar to the copy command but slightly different, and here's why. So first we're going to pick a shape to duplicate from our basic shapes over here. So I'm actually going to pick something that looks a little more interesting, like, let's go with a star, or sorry, a heart, okay? So I put my heart on the ground here, and it says to click the duplicate icon on the top toolbar, and the new shape will be placed exactly on top of the reference shape being the one that was previously located on the work plane. So if we press the duplicate button, which is right here, next to paste, you can see you can also use the hotkeys Control D so that you don't have to click on this every time. So if we go ahead and click the button, it doesn't look like much happened because the shape is directly on top of the other one. So if I click and drag, go to the next one here. If we click and drag that shape over, and let's say we want to make it kind of like steps. So we're going to click on this little sort of triangle up here at the top, click and drag up. You can see what this does is it lifts it into the air, okay? So now it says, with this shape selected, we made the change, and now it says to press the duplicate icon again. So if we click the icon again, you'll notice that it makes the exact same change from the previous version. So instead of putting it back on top of this shape where you have to then figure out exactly how much you moved it and lifted it up in the air, it already does all of those measurements for you. So if we continue to use our quick keys or pressing that button, so Control D, Control D, you can see that it continues to make those shapes in exactly those increments as we go. Okay, so go ahead to the next screen and you will see that you have completed your challenge. If you would like to try something different, what you can do is also drag over two shapes. So let's say I want to have a star and then a different type of star next to it, and we'll make one bigger than the other, or even maybe say one on top of the other. So let's actually make this one kind of pop up and out a little bit. We'll put it here in the middle. So you can see I have two shapes together. And now if I click and drag across both shapes and do my duplicate button, click and drag them over. Let's put them like this. And now do my quick keys, Control D, Control D. You'll notice that it does the same thing with both shapes at the same time. So go ahead and take your screenshot and put it on your journal page. Good job.